So today we are going to start the next application of Gauss law, application number 2, that is to find the electric field intensity due to infinitely long charged wire. For that, we will consider an infinitely long charged wire. Let this charge is positive. And here the linear charge density lambda, that is Q by L. Now suppose you want to calculate the electric field intensity at a distance R from the charged wire, and this is the point P where we want to find the electric field intensity. Now if you want to calculate electric field intensity at point P, according to the Gauss law, we will consider a Gaussian surface. Now this Gaussian surface must be symmetric with respect to the given charged object. Now because here it is a wire, so the Gaussian surface will be cylindrical in shape. You can visualize it in another way, like if we increase the dimensions of a wire, it will become a cylinder. So over here the electric field intensity will be perpendicular to the surface, and this is suppose E in magnitude. Over here if we talk about this area element, so this area element also have the direction same, perpendicular to the surface. So angle between electric field intensity and the area element is zero. Over here if we check the area element, the direction of area element is perpendicular to the cross sectional area, and here electric field intensity on this surface is perpendicular to the wire. So angle between these two is 90 degrees. Similarly over here area element is perpendicular to the surface dA, and electric field intensity is perpendicular to the surface of the wire. So over here again the theta is 90 degrees. Now we can consider this Gaussian surface is made up of three surfaces. One is S1, curved surface area. Second is S2, cross sectional area. And third one is S3, cross sectional area. Now over here, by the basic definition of Gauss law and electric flux, electric flux associated to the closed surface will be closed integral of electric field over area vector, which is equal to summation Q and closed upon epsilon naught. Now over here if we open this surface S, it will have three surfaces S1. On S1 we can see the angle between E and dA is zero, so it will be EDA cos zero. Now if we talk about the second surface S2, we can find the angle between E and dA is 90. Similarly for the third surface S3, again this is modulus of E dA and then cos 90 degrees, okay, and this is equal to Q enclosed upon epsilon naught. Now over here, let the length of this cylindrical Gaussian surface is L. So we can write Q equals to lambda L. This is the charge enclosed by this Gaussian surface. So my dear students, here E is constant in magnitude, integration of dA, that is area of curved surface, then Q enclosed, that will be lambda into L upon epsilon naught. Now over here again, this integration of dA, that will be 2 pi r L curved surface area, and this is lambda L upon epsilon naught. L cancel, so the electric field intensity, that is 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught lambda by r, or else you can write it like that, 2k lambda by r. Here you can see the electric field intensity is inversely proportional to r. So if you want to plot the graph between electric field and r, okay, y-axis electric field intensity, x-axis r, so this will be a rectangular hyperbola. It shows as r increases, the value of electric field intensity will decrease. Or else if we want to plot the graph between 1 by r and electric field intensity, then this will be a straight line passing through origin like that.